Hello.
Hello, is this Mr. Bradley?
What's up, man?
Is this Stephen Bradley?
Oh, Christ.
I see you guys haven't figured out your bullshit echo that I hear whenever I'm talking to you.
What?
We still haven't figured it out. I don't know why you hear the echo. And how dare you call it bullshit?
You unprofessional, dirty motherfuckers.
All right, we're on the air with Steve from Iwrestledabearonce. Steve, thank you for thanks for taking some time to hang out with us. And I want to remind our listeners that if you guys want to call in and talk to Steve, the correct number to call is 646-929-1357. It'll be...
Did you give out the wrong number?
He gave his own cell phone number earlier.
And just so you know, Seth Putnam lived a whole extra, 3 months after we interviewed him by phone. So for the next 3 months, live every day like it's your last.
Well, we've interviewed Steve. He was on the show last year.
Well, I think Seth Putnam started the curse.
Yeah. So. And, we've had Odorous on. Odorous is still alive. It's not...
Seth Putnam started the curse.
Peter Steele died two minutes ago.
The day,
that's true.
We mocked him on the show, and then he died.
You're right. So Seth Putnam did start the curse. So, but we've had more guests on since Putnam. They're all alive.
Yeah, well, Putnam died this week, so next week,
for now,
it's chronological.
Yeah.
So who did we have the week after Putnam? Because that person's dying next week.
It's like Final Destination. They all die in the right order.
Yeah.
Well, I guess we'll find out. I'll let you know.
Well, you might be able to catch Steve on Warped Tour this summer.
If he's alive.
We're not doing Warped Tour. That was last summer.
Oh, see? My news is just a year
already
behind.
Started. They got knocked off Warped Tour.
I guess you won't be able to see them on Warped Tour, not because they're dead. What are you guys doing this summer?
The appropriately titled All-Stars Tour.
Oh, that's right.
Because clearly we're all-stars of something.
Is this with Smash Mouth?
Yeah, I wish I was in Smash Mouth. I'll be talking to y'all faggots right now.
Or would you?
It's actually with Amur.
I'd be talking to a bunch of underage Malaysian boys in a hot tub somewhere right now. That's what I'd be doing.
You read stories about that on the air. It's crazy.
So, Steve, a few weeks
about
ago...
Smash Mouth, you mean, right?
Oh.
Not me.
Molesting Smash Mouth in Malaysia.
A few weeks ago, you guys put out this press release saying you guys were going black metal, this whole photo shoot.
Yes.
And then people start getting pissed about it. They're like, you guys are lame. And then you put out a song and you're not going black metal. And then people were pissed that you lied to them. How does it feel pissing
people
off?
People don't even know what to be mad about anymore, so that's good.
What should they be angry about? The fact that you said that you were going to go black metal, or the fact that you lied about saying you're going black metal?
Hopefully a combination of the two that results in them, now trying to kill me because I've been on your goddamn show.
The two things will combine.
What now?
Never mind. Keep going. I'll stop talking while you're talking.
Oh, okay. I never know. There's like a 2 second delay between when I talk and when you hear me talk. So
yeah,
I never know when the fuck I should talk and when I should just go fuck myself or what I should be doing.
You should just talk whenever you feel like talking. It's us that should adjust to your talking schedule. That's how I feel.
Fair enough. I'm on the All-Stars tour, goddammit.
You are an all-star. You don't have to take shit from anybody.
Well, I'm glad you recognize that fact.
Also,
makes it a lot easier.
Yeah. And also, you guys are shooting this video, this crazy video. And one of your people.
A movie.
It's a film. And I got the script
Short
for it.
Film.
I got the script for it, and it looks like some serious stuff. Can you tell us a little bit about it?
They sent you the script? Wow, nice. I don't even know if I have the final one yet.
You want me to forward it to you?
Yeah, no, it'd be good. Let me know. I need to start learning my lines or whatever. So
actually, Rob is trying out for your film. He's going to audition for it.
We could do a reading.
That would be sweet. I'm sure if you want to fly to North Carolina, you can definitely be... okay, I got it. You can be annoying interview guy that we fucking kill in the movie.
Oh, I really have to... that's like a reach for me. I really have to get into character.
The annoying part, I know, is what's the trouble. So it's, we'll step it up. You can work on that. Actually, you know what we'll do? To make it annoying, we'll just put a 2-second delay on when you talk, when we actually hear you talk in the actual film.
I see. Oh, wow.
See what I did there?
Steve is pissed.
Rob's also...
I turned it around.
He really hates the live cast.
I don't know if there's any conflict in your schedule, but you're supposed to play the lead singer of Smash Mouth in that biography.
Oh, is that that week? Oh, yeah. I'm sorry.
I just have to...
Damn it.
What's that guy's name?
Might as well be Walking on the Sun, right? The life and times of that fat guy.
Rob already shaved his face to the chin strap. It's perfect.
Walking on the Sun is definitely the name of the...
Yeah, that rules.
But his name is not in the title. It's Walking on the Sun, the fat guy story.
The fat guy from Smash Bros.
I mean, I accept the fact that I'm the tall, ugly one and I wrestled a bear one.
Oh,
so
get out of here.
Terms, that's good.
No, you're just the tall
Steve Harwell.
Okay. Also Steve. Wow.
Yeah, there you go.
Coincidence.
So I'm definitely going to die after this interview then, right? So we're still making that correlation between things, aren't we?
Yep, definitely.
Probably like 3 months.
But yeah, no, tell us about the...
Well, the guy from Smash Mouth's dead, right? He's got to be.
No, he's still alive.
Yeah.
For now.
Still banging hookers.
Yeah.
He might be married.
He's actually he actually dates hookers. That's the weird thing about it. Like, yeah. He takes hookers to awards shows and stuff.
They come home and they tell him, "No, I want to wait till we're married." And he's like, "All right, that's
with hookers."
I don't know. Got to go back inside. My neighbor's getting their lawn mowed.
Oh, that could be interesting. No, but we didn't really talk about this movie, right? This film.
Oh yeah.
Other than this new character that you're adding in.
It's going to be kind of like Pink Floyd, The Wall, but except with not good music and really bad acting.
Did you get Mr. Belding back again? Dennis Haskins?
I'm not at liberty to speak of the the multitude, nay, the plethora of appearances, but it'll be good, let's just say.
By the way, some people in this room, like Sid, would say that The Wall doesn't have good music or good acting.
No, I like Pink Floyd. No.
Oh, you do? Oh,
okay. I don't particularly love that album, but in general...
I thought you were anti-Pink Floyd.
They're fine.
You don't particularly like that album?
They're like the cynic of the 70s and 80s.
No.
I wouldn't.
No,
I don't
come on.
They'd be like, yes. All
right. Yeah, yeah.
Okay, fair
enough. Except, like, yeah, they'd be... I don't know. Yeah, except they were actually rich and famous and, you know, got everything that they deserved in life, whereas Cynic are not nearly rich and famous enough.
All right. True.
Straight talk.
I'll bring it there.
Yeah.
Shit just got real.
Listen, I'm resetting here, right? Wow, this guy.
He owned you just now.
You know what? I'm done with this interview.
Pwned. Good one.
Thanks for calling in, Steve. Their new
album.
Everyone
knows that this is why I love Rob, because Rob's like the first legitimate, dare I say, credible person to ever interview us, and it was fun. It was in a bathroom in New York City, so that's why I love Rob and give him shit.
Yay. I filmed that shit.
Your name's Rob, right? What's your name again?
My name is, yes, it is still still Rob. We also wrote about you. I think we were like the one of the first people to write about you guys, too.
That's true. Before, you and Metal Sucks. We suck before anyone else.
So you guys, you said you were still going to shoot this thing. What can people expect this film?
It's going to be out. We're lining all that up now. It's going to be out in time for like Halloween, because it's going to be a bloody, gory, like penis and vaginas and explosions and
awesome.
More consensual though,
so
right?
It's pretty legit. It's pretty, like, we read the script and we're just like, wow, so this is going to happen. Wow, holy shit, this is like amazing. So it's going to be good. And yeah, we're filming it like the start of July. So yeehaw.
Now, is this something that you're going to, like, is just an extended, like, Kanye video? Or are you taking this around to festivals? Or what's working with this? like, are we going to be seeing you at the Tribeca
Film
Festival?
Someone more intelligent than me to talk, and I was going to walk up and interrupt them and talk about Beyonce is really what's going to happen. That's going to be the trailer for the movie.
Oh, beautiful.
And then I'm going to go on the MTV Movie Awards and smash buttons on like a Korg Chaos pad and act like it's really artsy and cool. So yeah, it's really a Kanye West biography is what we're making.
I'm assuming there will be. I'm going to answer my own question here. Iwabo music in the film.
There will be. I'm not entirely even certain how much, but you know, there's going to be a good portion of the album throughout the movie.
I see.
Will there be any Iwabo featuring Kanye West tracks?
An Iwabo collabo? Is that what we're talking about?
You know, I mean, nice. Well played. I would love to do that, honestly. I mean, I'm talking shit. I think Kanye is a great rapper and has some good-ass beats, but he just does some really fucking ridiculous shit that I just blows my mind that people think they're famous and can get away with being fucking retarded. But anyway, I would do a Kanye collab. So if somebody can make that happen, I retract all the shit I just talked about Kanye West and let me know when my beat's over.
Right,
start getting the track laid down.
We can't get you Kanye West, but we might be able to hook up Ja Rule. Yeah. Is that okay? Cancellation?
Oh, my God.
He's in jail.
Well, he has one phone call a day.
Yeah.
Well, I'm sure Tone Loc is looking for some
work. Oh, jeez.
With the way our fucking phones work, you're going to get him from jail? I don't think so.
Phone check, fool.
Woo! Anyway. What?
What?
I got... So, I never know when like the conversation has started and if I'm a part of it or not. I'm so confused.
Just keep laughing. That's all you have to do, and it'll fit right in.
Yes, brilliant.
See, it totally works. Yes.
Yeah, we'll just edit around you. That's fine.
All right, we have some callers. We should go to the callers. And I just want to remind everyone that if you want to call in and talk to Steven, our number to call is 646-929-1357. I'm trying really hard not to give away my own number, guys. And let's make this happen.
Well, you already have. You might as well. I'm going to go back and listen to the podcast version of this, get your cell phone number, and just tweet it to everyone.
You should.
Actually, wait. No, I'm not. You have my cell phone number, don't you?
Yes.
God damn it. God damn
it. And we're going to bleep that out, so don't you worry. Anyway, so.
All right, good.
Let's take.
Jesus, now my other neighbor is getting their fucking lawn cut. I got to go back inside again.
Do you also have a lawn?
We do. We just don't cut it.
Fucking sellout.
Let's take 817. Landed? Is that you? Landed?
Yes.
You're on the air with Steven. What's your question?
What's up, buddy?
I would like to know what black metal influences you will have in your new album.
Oh.
Well, truth be told, almost none. But I think there's probably like two riffs on the whole record that could actually be considered black metal. So it wasn't a total lie. Mm-hmm. And just Emperor and only Emperor.
You're still going to do the face paint?
And King Diamond.
No?
What's up?
So you're still going to do the face paint anyway.
Oh, yeah. I mean, that's more important than the music, right? We got to do that.
Yeah.
All right, let's keep the callers going. We got Lexus on the air. Whoa. No, we don't.
Nope.
Lexus is gone.
Toyota? Is Toyota there?
Sam. Is this Sam on the line? Sam, are you there?
Hello?
You mean
hello?
Sam?
This is Sam.
No, it's Sam.
It's Sam.
What's up?
Sam, what's your question for Steven?
Oh, I just wanted to ask Steven what his favorite dinosaur was.
Oh, good question. Good question.
That is a great question. That's one of the best questions I've ever been asked in an interview. Oh. And the answer is there's no correct answer. But if
what?
In my head,
that's
I
like
had,
Inception.
In my head, I had to pick. It would probably be. Let's go with the Raptor Jesus. I'm going to pick Raptor Jesus.
Sam, what's your favorite dinosaur?
My favorite dinosaur? My favorite dinosaur is a Stephen Bradley-saurus.
Oh. Whoa.
Nice. Well played.
I think that was a come-on.
If that was real.
If he wants to get come-on.
That would be great.
It was real. I wrestled him once.
Oh, you got a little fun action.
Steven's got a boyfriend, Steven.
Wait, It's because the band name has Wrestle Once in it. I get it.
I get it.
I get it.
Thanks for your call, Sam.